knowledge, my students. Today we are going to start with History Class 11, Section 2, Theme 4, Part 7, The Central Islamic Lands. In the previous session, we had a discussion about the economic, trade and urbanization. In this session, we will continue with the trade and urbanization as well as we will read about the paper geniza and history. Paper geniza records and history. Let us read about the paper and the records and history, what it tells about the trade and commerce during the Islamic culture and spread of Islam. In the central Islamic lands, written works widely circulated after introduction of the paper. Paper made from linen came from China, where the manufacturing process was a closely guarded secret. In 1751, the Muslim governor of Samarkand took 20,000 Chinese invaders as prisoners, some of whom were good at making paper. For the next 100 years, Samarkand paper remained an important export item. Since Islam prohibited monopolies, paper began to be manufactured in the rest of the Islamic world. By the middle of the 10th century, it had more or less replaced papyrus, the writing materials made from the inner stem of a plant that grew freely in the Nile Valley. Now the demand for paper increased, and Abd al-Latif, a doctor from Baghdad, see his depiction of the idol student on page 98, and a resident of Egypt between 1193 and 1207 reported how Egyptian peasants robbed graves to obtain mummy wrapping made of linen to sell to paper factories. Now, paper also facilitated the writing of the commercial and personal documents of all kinds. In 1896, a huge collection of medieval Jewish document was discovered in sealed room, Geniza, pronounced Ganiza, of the Ben Ezra synagogue in Fustat. The documents had been preserved thanks to the Jewish practice of not destroying any piece of writing that contained the name of God. The Geniza was found to contain over a quarter of a million manuscripts and fragments dating as far as the mid-18th century. Most of the material dated from 10th to the 13th century, that is, from the Fatimid, Ayyubid and early Mamluk periods. These included personal letters between merchants, family and friends, contracts, promises of dowry, sale documents, laundry list, and other trivia. Most of the documents were written in the Judeo-Arabic, a version of Arabic writing written in Hebrew characters that was commonly used by the Jewish communities throughout the medieval Mediterranean. The Geniza document provides rich insights into personal and economic experiences, as also into Mediterranean and Islamic culture. The documents also suggest that the business skills and commercial techniques of the merchants of the medieval Islamic world were more advanced than those of their European counterparts. Guyton wrote a multi-volume History of the Mediterranean from Geniza records, And Amitabh Ghosh was inspired by Janisha Litter to tell the story of an Indian slave in his book, In an Antique Land. So this is about the beginning of the manufacturing of paper in the central Islamic land, dated back to the 9th and 10th century, and how the histories and records were preserved by the people. Now coming back to the trade and urbanization under the Islamic rule in Arab and Central Asian land. Now towards the eastern end, caravans of the Iranian merchants set out from Baghdad along the Silk Route to China via the oasis cities of Bukhara and Samarkand, Transoxiana, to bring Central Asian Chinese goods, including paper. Transoxiana also formed an important link in the commercial network, which extended north to Russia and Scandinavia for the exchange of the European goods, mainly fur. And Slavic captives, hence the word slave. Islamic coins used for the payment of these goods were found in the hoards discovered along the Volga River and in the Baltic region. Male and female Turkish slaves, Gulam, too were purchased in these markets for the courts of the caliphs and sultans. Now let us talk about the fiscal system and the market exchange. The fiscal system, the income and expenditure of the state, and the market exchange increased the importance of money in the central Islamic land. Coins of gold, silver, copper were minted and circulated, often in bags sealed by money changers, to pay for the goods and services. Gold came from Africa, Sudan, and silver from Central Asia, Zarafshan Valley, and precious metals and coins also came from Europe, which used these to pay for its trade with the East. Now, rising demands for the money forced people to release their accumulated reserves and idle wealth into circulation. Now, credit combined with the currencies to oil the wheels of the commerce. The greatest contribution of the Muslim world to medieval economic life was the development of superior methods of payment and business organizations. Letters of the credit, saq, origin of the word check, and bill of exchange, suftaja, were used by the merchants and bankers to transfer money from one place or individual to another. The widespread use of the commercial papers freed merchants from the need to carry cash everywhere and also made their journeys safer. The caliph too used the saq to pay salaries or rewards to the poets and minstrels. Now, although it was customary for merchants to set up family business or employ slaves to run their affairs, formal business arrangements were also common in which sleeping partners entrusted capital to traveling merchants and shared profits and losses in an agreed proportion. Islam did not stop people from making money so long as certain prohibitions were respected. For instance, interest-bearing transactions, riba, were unlawful. Although people circumvented usury in ingenious way, such as borrowing money in one type of coin and paying in another while discussing the interest as commission on the currency exchange. The origin of the bill of exchange. Now, although it was customary for the merchants to set up families Now we have completed up to here. That is the circulatory business and the origin of the bill of exchange. Now many tales of the thousands and one nights, Alf Laila, Walaila give us picture of medieval Islamic society, picturing characters such as sailors, slaves, merchants, and money changers. Now in the next session, section 2, theme 4, part 8, the Central Islamic Land, we will continue with the chapter. Om Namah Shivaya.